McDaniel, a Tea Party Republican, changed his mind this week about challenging Senator Roger Wicker. As we reported earlier, McDaniel has now announced his intentions to run in a special election.
The issues surrounding that decision are what will make Mississippi politics a bit of a spectacle in the weeks and months ahead. WCBI's Parker King speaks with political analyst Dr. Marty Wiseman, and Parker joins us live in the studio with more. Parker?
What McDaniel has done with this decision is given himself a little bit more time to build momentum for a seat he lost 2 years ago. His problem is his party could have other plans for that seat, and that division could give Democrats a chance to fill a seat that Cochran has kept red for decades.
State Senator Chris McDaniel switched to the November 6th special election for retiring U.S. Senator Thad Cochran's seat. That race is one of many political twists and turns in Mississippi.
It's going to be 36 months of just very intriguing politics all the way around.
Dr. Marty Wiseman is the former director of the Stennis Institute of Government and Community Development at Mississippi State University. He says McDaniel may have given himself more time to build his campaign between now and November, but his competition is former U.S. Secretary of Agriculture Mike Espy, a name as notable as Roger Wicker's.
It's not going to be any picnic beating him with his name recognition, so he's going to have to take it very seriously.
What's different about the November election is it's a free-for-all. Any candidate from any party willing to raise the funds can run.
Looking at the special election, because what you have there, whether you have 5 or 105 elected, everybody's in one pack, and whoever gets 50% plus one can win on the first day.
Or it could go into a runoff between the top two candidates. Tensions between McDaniel and state Republicans could potentially give Espy the upper hand.
You get 3 or 4 Republicans in there because you don't want McDaniel in there, the establishment side of the Republican Party, then and the Democrats coalesce around Espy, and you could have Espy take advantage of that 50% plus one because it gets split all over the place with the Republicans.
Which could give Espy a clear shot at the vacant seat, a seat Cochran kept red for over 40 years. Parker King, WCBI News.
Now, to clarify some more, this election would only give the winner of the special election the seat until the next official election in 2020. So if McDaniel wins this one and he wants to keep that seat, he'll have to raise money twice. And that's it.